Hello everyone. Let's look at an active demonstration of projectile motion. Here we have a little cannon that launches a ping pong ball vertically when the trigger hits this rod. The card is released with an initial constant velocity on a low friction track, so it will continue with a near constant horizontal velocity all the way along. After the ball is launched vertically, where will the ball land? Behind the cannon, back into the cannon, or ahead of the cannon? Pause and predict before continuing. Just as we saw with the horizontal launch, the velocity components are independent. Both the cart and the ball continue to move with the same constant horizontal or VX component. Even when the ball is in the air, it still has the same VX velocity, and the cart moves along likewise to catch it perfectly. Just as we saw with the horizontal launch, the velocity components are independent. Both the cart and ball continue to have the same constant horizontal or VX component. Even when the ball is in the air, it still has the same VX velocity, and the cart moves along likewise to catch it perfectly. Gravity provides a downward acceleration. This acts only to slow the vertical motion of the ball to zero, and then increase the speed in the downward direction. Just like we saw for 1D motion and for the strobed image of a horizontal launch. This is a schematic of the projectile motion. The velocities here are resolved into vector components in the X and Y direction. We have acceleration due to gravity acting downward. Therefore, there's no acceleration in the X direction, and VX remains constant throughout. Remember, the cart was moving with the same VX, so it aligned with the ball at all horizontal positions. In the Y direction, acceleration due to gravity slows the ball, bringing it to zero vertical motion at the peak position. And then gravity continues to accelerate the downward velocity. The first key point is these horizontal and vertical motions are completely independent. A second key point is to notice that, like we saw in last week's lesson, the acceleration due to gravity does not change direction. It always acts downward, as shown by the delta V. That is acceleration, the change in velocity per unit time. This is the opposite direction to the upward velocity, so the negative delta V decreases the positive velocity, and it is in the same direction as the downward velocity later, so the negative delta V increases the negative velocity. Keeping track of these signs or direction is extremely important. And so we independently apply the appropriate kinematic equations here for each component. For constant horizontal velocity, the acceleration is zero, and the velocity is constant. For the constant vertical acceleration, acceleration is constant, and we have these familiar equations. Thus, any 2D problem is just a connected set of two 1D problems, where I like to use the following reminders. AY stays the same throughout. It doesn't change direction. It's always acting downward. VY buys us time. It sets the stopwatch. And so we usually use these equations to find the time. Finally, VX runs the distance. It goes the distance in the given time available based on VY above. I'll add to that last bit of advice here. Don't try to memorize all the different forms of the kinematic equations. All you need is this basic set of equations. For constant velocity, we've got this basic definition that we can rewrite in a useful form. For constant acceleration, we've got that basic definition that we again can rewrite in a basic form. And if we remember the quadratic equation for position as a function of time, and this equation that eliminates time, we have everything that we need. And if we rewrite the same quadratic equation here, but for the x component, however, remembering that the acceleration over here is zero, you'll notice that we get the same equation as above. How beautiful is that? We have one less thing to remember. Everything else is just keeping track of those signs and subscripts, knowing when and where to use the negative acceleration due to gravity, and then popping in zeros where appropriate, particularly setting our initial time to zero and setting initial velocities and positions to zero when appropriate. After that, it's just basic algebra.